Köszönöm, képviselő úr. Martin David képviselő úr következik 2 percben.
Thank you very much, President. President, there are 4 European Union member states of the G20, as well as the European Union itself. And sadly for all of us, our growth is stagnating, while by and large the growth of the other G20 countries is rapidly expanding. So while I welcome the Commission's investment pledge that we heard today to kickstart the European economy, I think we have to be realistic and say that we cannot have sustained economic recovery by endogenous means alone. We need to look to exogenous growth in order to get our economy really moving and to sustain our growth. And that means expanding our international trade agenda. And as the world's biggest market, we're not yet realising our full potential. The G20 reaffirmed its commitment to the multilateral trading system, something I and my group welcome. We welcome the fact that the Bali package has been given a kickstart as a result of the G20 negotiations. But for the immediate future, multilateralism is not going to be the answer, sadly, but realistically. So we have to look at our bilateral trade agenda. We have to make sure that the Singapore and the Canadian Free Trade Agreement is ratified. We have to make sure that we succeed in our negotiations with the US and Japan. We have to ensure that we get a good investment agreement with China. But we have to ensure that we do all of these things not at any price, but at the values, funny enough, set out by the G20. We have to ensure that these agreements include an emphasis on fair growth, an emphasis on sustainable development and fair labour standards, and tax transparency and strong financial regulation. And if we can achieve that in our bilateral trade agreements, we can contribute to the G20 objectives and contribute to expanding the European economy. Thank you, President.
Köszönöm, képviselő úr. A következő hozzászólónk Danti képviselő úr. Képviselő úr, 1 perc áll rendelkezésére.
Grazie, Presidente. Signor Commissario, colleghi. Il vertice del G20 di Brisbane segna una svolta nella risposta alla crisi economica che soffoca il nostro continente.